my back. You see what I did to Mans? If I run it back, I'm gonna
put the man in the stretch. I wanna see it. Do it.
Yo, that, hey, that only takes two seconds. It only takes.
You run that back, that's when it fires everything.
Why you gotta sell him? Why you gotta do that though? Why? But why?
If you run it back, it's solidifies.
Loma wants two rematches.
Why? It's just one. He can get beat up again. But it solidifies everything.
My man's gonna give me a rematch. Why I gotta give him after texting that ass? Talking about his shoulder.
I was just
talking about his shoulder.
Y'all finish up. We gotta go.
Talking about his shoulder.
According to Egypt Clemens, who did an interview with BoxingScene.com, said that Lomachenko is back in training, but he's not doing anything with the right shoulder that was surgically repaired. Clemens expects Lomachenko to be good to go this spring. Now, the last time we saw the former unified lightweight champ is when he got in the ring with Teofimo Lopez, the takeover, and he lost the controversial 12-round decision. Not really controversial to me because I thought Lopez won, but controversy in the boxing world. And Lomo last week brought more controversy to the situation when he said the judges were bribed or paid off. After the fight was over, Lomachenko's manager, Clemens, said that Lomachenko hurt his shoulder in training camp, but he was taking painkillers to reduce the pain so he'd go on with the fight. Lomachenko's father was against him going into that fight, but they did it anyway. And that's why I'm not buying the excuse. Because you knew you were injured, you could have postponed the fight and do it again. Now, Lomo also did an interview with The Ring to try to clear his name. He said he misunderstood what the interviewer was asking. He says he doesn't think the judges were bribed. He said he think they were biased against him because of the wide margins of the scores. I know one of the judges gave him one round. I had an 8-4 for Teofimo, possibly 7-5, but I went 8-4 for Teofimo. My thing is this, Wilder claims he got cheated twice. Lomachenko says the judges were biased against him in the first fight. So why would you want to go in that same environment where you didn't get a fair shake the first time or the second time, according to you? Clemens claims that Lomachenko wants an immediate rematch. He also says he wants a big fight at 135 if he can't get Teofimo Lopez. And if he can't get a fight at 135, he will move down to 130 and look for a big fight, which could be the winner of the Miguel Burchett-Oscar Valdez fight, or the young kid, Shakur Stevenson, has been asking for the fight against Lomachenko. I wouldn't mind seeing Miguel Burchett against Lomachenko. That's a fight I wanted to see for a while. Miguel Burchett's a big junior lightweight. Another good fight, it's just a fantasy fight for me, it won't happen, but Miguel Burchett against Teofimo Lopez. But at the end of the day, a lot of people are calling Teofimo Lopez to run it back. Even Lomachenko wants a rematch, and he says Lopez told him out of 100 times they fought, he would beat him 100 times. Loma says, cool, I'm not asking for 100 times. I'm asking for a rematch. And I've been on the record saying this before. Would I like to see a rematch? Yeah, I would like to see it again and see what happens. Does Teofimo Lopez owe him a rematch? I don't think so. He did what he needed to do. It's Lomo and his manager's responsibility to put a rematch clause in there, and they didn't do it. Anyway, it's a lucrative opportunity for Teofimo Lopez. He said he wants big money fights. Well, here you go. The rematch will be very lucrative. Anyway, leave your thoughts and comments below. Jay Beezy. Subscribe to the channel. I'm gone.